Oh, hey, didn't see that. Just joshing. G'day team, welcome to another video. Today's video is gonna be a bit of a casual update, just to let you know what's going on and where I'm at. In the last 2 weeks, I haven't posted a video, so I thought I'd share with you. Now listen carefully, I don't really like making these kinds of videos because they're obsolete in 2 weeks, you know? Nobody wants to watch an update about someone's life when it's already 3 weeks beyond that point, right? It's kind of null and void. What I'd much rather be doing is just posting in the community tab. Here's the issue. To get access to the community tab, you need 1,000 subscribers. Now I've got 800. That's awesome. Two months ago, I was on like 230. So I'm really pumped. I feel really encouraged, and I'm thankful to all the people who's hopped over to join us on this channel. But here's the challenge. Let's see if we can get to 1,000. Then the 2 or 3 hours I spend making and filming and editing these videos, I can put into the other videos that I'm currently working on, instead of wasting time making something like this. So, you know, thanks to everyone for joining in the last few months. Let's get 1,000. We're so close. At the rate we're going, I reckon we can get there in maybe 2 weeks. I don't know. That would be pretty cool. And then, yeah, I don't have to set up the lights and the camera and the audio just to say, hey guys, I'm not dead, I'm still alive, and I can spend this time working on other stuff. Speaking of which, why haven't I posted in the last 2 weeks? Well, as you can tell by my surroundings, I'm not really in Shanghai anymore. I may have mentioned it a couple of videos ago, but I've moved to Shenzhen. So since I got back from Yunnan, I've been packing things and shipping things and shangfenging things and getting everything sent to Shenzhen. I've now been here for, this is my third day, so I'm in the process of now unpacking everything, buying new stuff that the house doesn't have, all that kind of jazz. It's fairly hectic and I haven't had time to sit down, excuse the metro, it's above ground and just to my left there. I kind of like it because it snakes pretty cool and goes over the hills, and you can see the King Ki Tower in the background. That's the city center, and this goes all the way there and then into Hong Kong actually. So it looks nice, but it's noisy as. Anyway, speaking of noise, down below me is all this construction site. It's a government library that's going up. That's pretty intense. It's their lunch break now, so this is as quiet as it gets. And it's from 7 to 11, that's in 10, not 11 a.m., 11 p.m. Shanghai, 8 to 5, manageable. 7 to 11, man. With the extra hours, I hope they finish soon, because 7 to 11 for long is gonna drive me and the cat insane. Anyway, yeah, apart from that, it's a pretty stunning view. If you cut it off like here, like I have this layout, it's quite beautiful, I quite enjoy it. The rain's coming in on the distance, but when the sun's out, it's particularly stunning. So yeah, you know, it's been pretty hectic. I haven't had time to go out and film a video. The reason why I've moved to Shenzhen is I've got a new job. I'm actually stepping down. In Shanghai, I was the head of my department for PE, art, music, and ICT. And in Shenzhen, I'm actually just gonna be a homeroom teacher. So less responsibility. But it's still, I consider it a move up because everything is better. it's a school with a better reputation, it's a better pay package, it's better compensation. And you know, I'm sure with my management experience and my, you know, passion for education, in the future I'll get those management roles again. But for the moment, I'm just stepping back and focusing on my core responsibilities as a teacher and improving my craft, which is why I've moved to Shenzhen. When things are a bit more settled and it's not so hectic, I plan on going out there somewhere and continuing to make videos in my normal style with the lovely B-roll and the journey through the city and things of that effect while I talk about a topic. But at the meantime, not really practical. Probably the next video I do that isn't something casual like this will be about my teaching journey from university in New Zealand studying education to the job I had working with the military to moving to China to becoming an English teacher and all that kind of nonsense, because I'm gonna be getting into a lot of education-based videos and a lot of teaching-based videos. And when you watch them, I don't want you to think I'm right because of my experience, but I want you to know that my experience has informed my opinions. So in order for you to know that, you need to know what my experience is. So I'm gonna share that with you as a sort of like, I don't know, journey over the last, what has it been? 6 years, wow. 6 years since I graduated from university, so that when you do watch my videos talking about teaching in China or whatever, or the new laws that have been proposed, I'll discuss those later as well. You can, if you disagree with me, that's fine. At least you know where I'm coming from, right? And that's the point, is if you do disagree with me, that's okay. I want to know if you disagree with me. If I'm wrong, I need to learn about it, right? Lifelong learners, yeah? So don't ever feel free, always feel free to post a comment, to say I'm wrong, to say I'm right, whatever, that's fine. Let's engage in discussion in these videos, team. Let's be actually not closed-minded, not bigoted like some other channel commenters you might see. It's insane what people post on these China YouTubers. Let's be a channel that is not afraid to admit when we're wrong, and is continually growing in our thoughts and opinions. Excuse the curtain, it's might be blocking off the view. So yeah, that's the plan moving forward. I've currently got two videos that are in production. I've already filmed them. One of them is my New Zealand trip that I did with Lily way back in February. For the new subscribers who don't know who Lily is, she's my girlfriend. She's in some of my older videos, mostly my travel videos, Thailand to be specific. But I want to feature her more in the future because she's got wildly differing opinions to me about many things, and I think a lot of my audience will probably agree with her more than you agree with me. Wise decision. So I think that'll be cool just to see, and we can discuss some relevant hot topics going on. And then I've got another video which is a summary of my trip to Yunnan. Spoiler, it's stunning. Yunnan was so amazing, so beautiful. I took a lot of footage there, but nothing that I can really construct into like a travel-based story. So I'm just gonna talk about the trip and overlay it with some footage. That's also in production at the moment. But these kind of travel footage, travel videos, I shoot like 5,000 hours of footage, so they take a lot longer to edit. But they're coming, they're in the pipe works. So you can expect that. Yunnan was amazing, by the way. We went to Kunming. Oh, curtain! You see, I still got some work to do on the setup here. I'm shooting outside because I haven't quite figured out my studio space inside. I'm still working on it. I've got a couple ideas, but nothing I'm happy with. So I thought I'd share with you my balcony where I have my morning coffees now as a part of my routine. And I watch the construction workers. The other day I saw this guy, it was quite funny. The big drill machine's turning and he sees it coming and he really cool just leans out of the way and it stops in front of him and he comes like, what a cool cat. Then it backs up, bam, hits him in the head and he falls over backwards into like knee deep mud and water. I wish I was recording because it was one of the moments where, you know, you only see that stuff happens when you're a geek like me and you spend 2 hours every morning watching these people do stuff. Anyway, what was I saying? I've distracted myself. Yunnan is stunning. We went to Kunming, Dali, Lianjing. Oh my, I can't even remember the name. Lianjiang, I can't remember the name. And then Shangri-La. And all of them were stunning. Like every city I fell in love with. My favorite was probably Dali. It's a mountain city with a lake at like 2,300 meters elevation, and it's just beautiful gardens and beautiful lakes and beautiful towns and beautiful mountains. It was honestly stunning. I could retire in a place like that quite happily. So look forward to that video. Anyway, that's my rambling nonsense for you. Excuse me yelling, I'm trying to create as much. I've got the gain really low on my microphone to try and separate the noise from the background a bit. Yeah. So let's get to 1,000 team. If you only watch one of my videos and then never again, don't worry, don't bother subscribing. But if you're on your second of my videos, maybe your third, then come on. What are you doing? Hit the subscribe button, give us a like. Let's get to 1,000 so that I don't have to waste time making these videos and I can just use the community tab feature. I really want it. I feel so bad when I go 2 weeks like this without speaking to y'all. No, I'm not dead. I promise, I'm still making videos. Anyway. I know I'm still working on a way to sign out. Goodbye.